So today we're going to talk about the sciatic nerve. And there's two different reasons why you would have sciatic nerve pain. It's pain down the back of the leg, and it can go all the way down into the foot. One is more of a structural problem where the low back curve is not there. And I'll put a couple of videos down below of a technique to help put the curve back in, especially if you're sitting all day in front of your computer. But there's another underlying cause of sciatic nerve pain that I want to talk about, which is more internal, and there's something happening to the nerve itself. And it has to do with an imbalance of omega-6 to omega-3 fatty acids. Omega-3 fatty acids are the anti-inflammatories, and omega-6 are more inflammatory. Now, we need both of these fats, but we need them in the right ratios. An average American is really heavy on the 6 and very, very low on the 3. They have an imbalance, and that creates a lot of inflammation and nerve pain. And it affects the lipids, the myelin sheath around the nervous system, but especially to the sciatic nerve. What's unique about the sciatic nerve, it's one of the biggest nerves in the body. It's about the width of my thumb, so it's a huge nerve. And if you have an imbalance, where you don't have enough of this and you have too much of this, it can really target the sciatic nerve. Let me touch on omega-6 for a little bit. It's called linoleic acid. There's a condition that's called oxidized metabolites of linoleic acid. Basically, when these fats or their byproducts become oxidized, it creates a massive inflammatory situation in the body, in the arteries, in your brain, in the nervous system. This compound, another word for it is OXLAM, is the most abundant oxidized fatty acid in your blood. In 1909, we consumed only 2 grams of vegetable oil, which really is the seed oils. Now, or shall I say about 10 years ago in 2010, we were consuming 80 grams of vegetable oil every single day. That is 720 calories. If you're consuming about 2,000 calories a day, that's like 1/3 of all your calories is this type of fat. And the problem is that it makes up your cell membranes, so it creates a lot of problems throughout the entire body. It has a 1 to 2 year half-life. It doesn't break down very easily. This is what you need to do if you have sciatic nerve pain or any nerve pain. Decrease the vegetable oils. Start to read labels. Avoid the soy, the canola, the corn oil, the cottonseed oil, even the safflower oil. Cook with coconut oil and butter. You can totally use olive oil. That's omega-9. It's actually very, very good for you. You also want to increase your omega-3 fatty acids, the fish oils, the cod liver oil. Consume more fish, seafood. Sardines, that's another good one. And the last thing I would recommend is to get some gamma linoleic acid. Now, this is an omega-6 fatty acid, but it's more anti-inflammatory. It specifically can increase the blood flow to the nerve itself, as well as increase the nerve transmission. There's been some real interesting nerve conduction velocity testing using this and improving the conduction of the flow of that nerve. And that would be either evening primrose oil or borage oil. Give it some time to work. And in the meantime, watch my other videos on sciatica. I put the link down below.